Braithwaite of Braithwaite Physiotherapy, helping you to move beautifully. Today, we're going to revisit one of my favorite topics, tendinopathy. And I know we've done a couple of videos in the last few months on this topic where we talked about first using isometric exercise for pain management and then eccentric exercise for tendon remodeling, so making it stronger and tougher. And now we're going to talk about another aspect of tendinopathy that is important in later stage recalcitrant returning type problems. So this is for those types of tendon problems where you've had some success, you've had some healing, but the problem still seems to be somewhat challenging, and then it continues to return. You can easily re-injure it. And one of the reasons for that chronic nature of this injury is that along with the tendon tissue being messed up in the injury, the nervous contribution, the nerve contribution to that muscle and tendon unit is also dysfunctional in the case of a tendinopathy. So every muscle has a nerve that supplies signals from the brain down to the muscle, whatever muscle it is that is attached to the tendon. And that signal from the brain to the muscle can become excited, extra excited, or inhibited, so not enough signaling. And we know that in cases of tendinopathy, the signaling is not normal, it's dysfunctional. And so one of the last sort of things that we need to focus on in tendinopathy rehabilitation is in normalizing that neural signal from the brain down to the muscle tendon unit. And the good news is that it's not actually that complicated to start working on that. One of the best things that you can do is do your traditional eccentric strength training exercise with an external auditory cue that will trigger your signaling from the brain to the muscle to normalize into a better, healthier level of activity. So what I mean by that is, you may recall our later stage exercise we were doing, if we were using the example of an Achilles tendinopathy down here, which is a very common one that I dealt myself with last year, we do an eccentric exercise. And in this case, with this muscle, that is a tendon or a heel drop, right? So I get up onto a little step like this, I have a weight in my hand, and I'm doing drops down. See how I'm helping up with the strong side? If this is my right side is my injured side, I'll help up with the left and drop down on the right, just like that. Drop down, right? And that's where we were in our late stage rehabilitation at last video. We were doing 5 sets of 15 repetitions of that. Now, if we add an external auditory cue, like, for example, a metronome beat, which I have right here on my phone, this is a BlackBerry, but I could still get a metronome on this thing, we can start to add in that sound cue that we were talking about. So I'm going to start my metronome. Can you hear that? Probably not. Can you hear that? Okay. So I've got the cue on. It's going at 1 beat per second, so 60 beats per minute. And that's going to help me to cue my heel drop. I'm going to go 3 seconds on the up phase and 4 seconds on the down phase, which is quite slow. So it'll look like this. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get the idea? Pretty straightforward. And we can listen to our metronome to help us cue those second timers. And that external auditory cue will help us to normalize the brain signaling part of the pathology. So try that. The exercise prescription is 4 sets of 8 repetitions with that 3 seconds up, 4 seconds down. Now we were doing Achilles tendon example here. Each different tendon, you could pick a different exercise, and that's something that you can discuss with a physiotherapist if you're unsure about which exercise is most appropriate for your tendon problem. But the overall arching idea will apply across tendinopathy. So if you have any questions about that, of course, don't hesitate to reach out. And James Braithwaite here at Braithwaite Physiotherapy, helping you to move beautifully.